Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you a fix for El Capitan. If you're getting this error while you're running the beta version of El Capitan, which says this application requires the legacy Java SE runtime, which is unavailable for this OSX, and because of that your application isn't opening, there's a fix for it, and I'm going to show it to you now. The first thing you're going to need to do is download all these three packages. Now, when you download these three packages, you're going to go to the website. You'll be downloading this Java package, which I'll give you the link in my comments area. You'll be downloading this uninstall package, which is all free, at least for a temporary amount of time, so that you could do the fix. And Pacifist, which you're going to click on disk image in order to download them. So those three packages you're going to download. You'll see a file called Pacifist, one called JavaForOSX.2014, and the uninstall package, which is actually the application. Once you've downloaded them, drag them to the desktop like I have it to make it easy. You're going to be double-clicking on Pacifist. It's going to open. And we'll skip that. Here we go. And what you're going to do is take the application and simply drag it to your desktop. Once you're done copying it, you'll have it on your desktop like this. The reason you need it on your desktop is there's another area where you're going to have to open this file, and dragging it on top makes it easy. The next step would be to go to this file, which you download and will be in your downloads folder. Double click on it, it'll mount it, and grab the package file and put it also on your desktop, like that. And then, of course, grab from your download folder this uninstall package. Okay? So you'll have these three things and you're ready to go. The next step is we go to step four, where we're going to open the PKG app and search for the JDK. And uninstall the versions of JDK on your Mac. So you're simply going to open up this application and it's going to search for all of the items that are on your computer, and you're going to use this little search box to search for Java or JDK. So let's wait for it to load. Now I've already done the update on this computer, so I won't be actually running the uninstall. Now I'm going to continue trial for now, so you can do a trial version. Of course, if you like the software, you should always purchase it. Now you could type in Java or JDK. And whatever comes up, there might be two items or three items, simply click on it and uninstall from right down here on this little button here. Once it finishes uninstalling, you're done with this step. The next step would be step five, where you're going to open and drag it to your desktop. If you haven't done that already, that's just talking about opening up this package and dragging it onto the desktop like that. Now once you have it on your desktop, you're going to run this command in your terminal. So we'll copy that. You can simply copy that from it, and you'll be opening up your terminal window, and you will be pasting that command in, hitting return, and that's it. Once you're done with that, your computer will restart, and after your computer restarts, drag the JavaForOSX package, which is this one that we have here, on top of the Pacifist application like that. And as you can see, it's going to open. At this point, well, you're going to highlight these two items that are here, and you're going to click install, and you're going to let it run through the installation process. Once you're done installing it, you should pretty much be done, but it will ask you during the installation for you to put in your admin password. So if you're not an admin on your computer, then you need to be in order to do this fix. Once you're done with the install and you have put in your admin password, you're now going to click this again, which is the install, and you're going to actually run through the installation from this package. And after you do that, you will be able to open up your applications. Now, if you get an error from this when you're installing, then the fix has not been applied properly, so you should try to do it again. Because you should, at the end of all of this, double-click on this application packager and basically install it onto your computer. So I hope that helps. It helped me. I tried a whole bunch of fixes before I found that this one worked, so I wanted to share it with everybody. So I hope you enjoyed listening, and good luck in fixing this particular error. Thanks for listening.